Analytics with Max. In this video, I'm going to talk about reference versus duplicate options in Power Query. This request came in a comments session and I thought it is very interesting to me as well. So I request you to do some more comments, whatever topics you are interested in. If you want to know, just let me know in the comments so that I can prioritize and I will try to take it in upcoming videos. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin our today's topic. So we are in Power BI and let me go to Power Query. So I am in transform data. So we are familiar, like we have data sets here, you will import from different tables. And there is certain times you want to duplicate a query or reference. Say for example, duplication we do because you need to get the different order type and name by group by columns in a different column or dimensions. It can be any reasons, right? So in that case, you may have a doubt whether I need to duplicate or reference. What is the core difference between these? The first and foremost difference is that duplicate, once you do it, once at the moment you do the duplicate of this particular table, whatever in the current state when and you press the duplicate, the relationship between these two tables is closed. I mean, there won't be further relationship between these two. Whereas the reference is always pointing to your table. This is the core difference, what I'm trying to say. Let's check it out in this demo. Now we have four steps here and let me delete some of the columns and remove columns. I'm just changing the data type of this particular column. Now you can see here there are different steps over here and I will do the duplicate of this table now, okay? And I will rename it as POS dupe for short, okay? Duplicate. Then I will do the reference of this table now. Then I will say this one as reference. Okay, now this is fine. Now what is the difference over here is, like, you see there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 steps here. These six steps are copied. So in order to copy the steps, whatever you have done, mostly it is not as simple as this. Usually when you do a Power Query with some cleansing exercise, there will be a lot of steps, around 15 to 20 steps you have done. And that step can be used for some other concept also or some other table, same steps. Then in those cases, you can copy or duplicate these steps, right? So this is why you will go for duplicate. And as soon as you duplicate it, there is no relation between these two, okay? Relation in the sense, the source, this belongs to one table. I mean, this is considered as one table. This is considered another table. That's it. What about reference? When you see the reference, it is always pointing to the source. So there is no steps are copied. It always points whatever steps applied in this source table will be also copied over here, right? I mean, it's not a steps copied. It is just pointing. It's a pointer to the whatever source table it is. That is what the core difference between duplicate and reference. In order to understand it better, now these six steps are copied and we have just this one is a pointer to this table. Any changes you do it here, I am deleting these two columns now in this. Any changes you do here, the duplicated column will not have the two steps. Whereas you can see that will reflect in your reference table. So now I'm deleting one more column here for understanding. I'm deleting sales date here. So sales date disappeared from here. Whereas in duplicate column, it will still appear. Okay. Whereas in reference column, the sale date is gone. The duplicate, when you did duplicate, at we are at this sixth step, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? Change type. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Those six steps are retained there. As soon as you duplicate it, there is no connection. Whatever changes you do, it will not reflect. Okay. So when you will use it? So basically, like reference table, when some steps are applied here and you are creating subset of it, like you for Chennai and Hyderabad and Bangalore, you create three different tables. Some of the steps you applied here should also reflect in some other reference table. Then you go for reference. Duplicate is just you copy hard coded work, whatever you did, you want to apply it for some again, right? Maybe after applying it, you come up through these two lists. From here, you need to get these two tables or these two columns after applying all possible combinations. In those cases, once you duplicate it, then you do the removal of these columns. I mean to say, like, you apply 10 to 15 steps. Okay, then you need only from that 15 steps applied, you want to compare the two columns here, right? Then you say like you want distinct values from that. Okay, there can be different scenarios I'm saying. So let us try to duplicate this. Duplicate, and I want distinct values from this location column. Then you will delete all the rows. Okay, then keep this one. You say duplicate column. So this will, I mean, not duplicate what I'm doing, remove duplicate. So this gives you a proper list. This can be acting as a dimension or any other reference. So this is how you need to do it, right? So this is the core difference between a duplicate and reference. I hope you understand the core concept behind that. And one last point about the duplicate is, like, it consumes memory, and when you do the reference, it will not consume the memory. It will always do a pointer. Hope you like this video. Hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.